Restoring Illinois to greatness. This is Illinois Rising, presented by the Illinois Policy Institute and hosted by AM 560's Dan Proft.
And joining me on this special edition of Illinois Rising is Pat Hughes, co-founder of the Illinois Opportunity Project. And Pat, we were talking at the break. One of the things that's sort of remarkable, because conservatives get tagged all the time with being, oh, you're ideological and you're unyielding and you're obstinate, you have to forge compromise. You know, it turns out that the position that Rahner's folks are taking is they're the ideologues. They're saying, I feel that a compromise is necessary. This is my position. So I'm going to wishfully impose it on the entire electorate, even when presented with the evidence that the electorate is rejecting it out of hand.
It's
just interesting.
And it's crazy politically. It's politically stupid. I don't know how else to say it.
Let's get back to the phone. Sharon in Itasca, you're on Illinois Rising.
Hey, Dan and guests. Thanks for taking my call. You mentioned Crane Chicago Business. I think that all forces of nature are coming together to create Armageddon for Illinois. I looked at all the listings. This is a little off topic, but all of the municipalities which have opted out of the forced sick pay leave, which is a minimum of 5 days a year, and the forced minimum wage increase, and there is only like maybe not even 25% of the municipalities who have opted out, who Tony Prankwinkle, the tyrant, says are selfish. So between that lets you know what the electorate thinks. Not to mention Bruce Rahner, I think, buying into a real bluff here that he's going to lose. You are absolutely correct. We don't want to see this happen here, and you're going to see more hemorrhaging than you have ever seen before. But everything seems to be pointing to a single, strong-armed, even stronger-armed government like Springfield really hammering down on the public. And they have no idea how many small people run businesses, pizza places, taco places. In one municipality in Addison, you have a lot of new immigrants who run these fast food places. If they have one or two people there, that's about it. If you think that they're going to participate in this, they're a lot smarter than the multi-generational Americans who have been here. I think that Bruce Rahner is taking a plug nickel if he signs on to this, but that's just my call.
Thanks for the call, Sharon. Appreciate it. And I just have this image in my head of Bruce Rahner as the skipper in the perfect storm, trying to climb that wall of water.
It's a big wall of water.
We can make it.
What happened in that movie? Nothing good, Dan.
Yeah, I don't want to.
Poor Mark Wahlberg.
Yeah, spoiler alert. All right, he's on at 10 p.m. tonight, but that's not enough ranting time for Sean from Elmwood Park, who's on Illinois Rising. Sean?
It's not enough because I heard the call from Ann, and that's the problem with this state. The Republicans who say, I'll take another tax increase. We'll compromise a little bit. We've already lost this battle. This is the wrong guy for the job. His offer is a loss. His offer is, what do you mean you're going to cost me another 32% tax increase? What do you mean you're going to freeze my property taxes versus the way I'm supposed to be taxed, which is on the value of the property? See, this guy, he's a Democrat. And when you announce that his wife is his consultant and the other guy's a consultant, they're Democrats too. And they think like Democrats. So what I want you and Pat to do is pull a straw, and whichever one gets the short one, primary him, because he's the wrong man for the job. He doesn't have the strength.
God, I hope you get the short one, Dan.
Thanks.
Either one of you. Primary him, because if you're listening to the calls, what they're really doing is they're begging for another option. It's early in the game. Throw a wrench in the system that you hate. And primary him, because either one of you is 10 times better than this lurch and the scarecrow wife. Get him out of my way, because my offer to you is this: nothing, not another penny. And you straighten out what you got to straighten out, or I'm coming to visit you.
Thanks for the call, Sean from Elmwood Park. Yeah, more of that at 10 o'clock tonight. But Sean is pointing to something, if we can strip it out here. What you're doing with tax increases, you're saying, Illinois families, you failed the government.
Yeah, that's
what I'm saying.
You haven't done enough. You have not done enough. You haven't done your fair share. By the way, Sean is very loose with our time and our commitments, I have to tell you.
Well, this is the end of our special edition of Illinois Rising. Back next Sunday, 3 o'clock, and then we'll pick up what happens in the special session this week on Chicago's Morning Answer, me and Amy Jacobson, starting at 5 a.m. tomorrow. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon.